my friends, this is Lady Flora, and in this video I wanted to give you a quick review of a math curriculum that we are using called Miquon Math. And at the end of this video, my daughter is going to tell you what she really thinks of this math curriculum. But before we do that, I should tell you that I am a working homeschooling mom to a 3-year-old boy man cub and a 6-year-old girl songbird. And our newest addition, baby professor, who is 6 months old. So I got this curriculum used on eBay, and I wasn't exactly sure where to start with it. This red book is about second grade, I believe, and then this orange book is like a first grade or kindergarten book. So I got the red book because my daughter is doing really good, like first grade type math, and I thought that she'd be ready to get into this right away. And in some ways she was. She did really well with this at first, and I started thinking, oh, why did I get the orange book? We're not even using it. But then it turned out that we went back to the orange book. So so let me just tell you a few things about this curriculum. So it's called Miquon Math, and it's from like the 1960s. So it's made for the classroom. It's not actually made for homeschoolers, but a lot of homeschoolers use it, and you need cuisenaire rods to use it. And I love cuisenaire rods. I have some, and I love using them to teach math. In fact, I have another video, it's a little crazy, that shows how we use our cuisenaire rods. This curriculum, so they have different colored books. The orange book being the easiest, followed by the red book. And then there is a blue, a green, a yellow, and a purple, and they cover elementary math. You have to have this book when you're doing Miquon Math. And there are other books that come in the series. There's a book called The First Grade Diary, and there's a book called Notes to Teachers, and you don't need those unless you enjoy reading about math curriculums. I just don't have time to read stuff like that. I need to just get into it with my kids right away. So I just went ahead and got this one. So let's say in the orange book you open up to this page. This is the second page, and you have absolutely no idea what is going on here with these amoeba-like shapes. It's very like abstract art. But you can look down here and it will say, refer to lab sheet annotations, page 14. So in this worksheet, for example, the instructions are down here. You are using cuisenaire rods, and each child is given a cuisenaire rod to try and match their sets to. So if you've got a 2 cuisenaire rod, you would hold it up to this square and match it with the 2 shapes. We went straight into the red book. I think I mentioned that before. And it starts off with even and odd. And here's an example where you make pairs, and then you find out if you have an even or odd number of pairs, and then you write down the amount of items in each group. And that way, you learn about even and odd. And we kind of already knew about even and odd, so we did that a little bit as review. Here's another example where we did odds and evens. Now in this one, this is the red book, so this is more like a second grade type book. We are expected to know the answer and then say whether it is even or odd. So this was a tad challenging, and there's no equal sign, so it was a little bit tricky for my daughter at first. And then here is some dot to dot, which of course is always enjoyable. Now this was cool. This was cuisenaire rods, but it was a little complicated. So we had to put a 10 cuisenaire rod here, and then a 1 rod here, a 2 rod here, a 3 rod here, and then just explore how it made the numbers. I really like the aesthetic of this book. It doesn't have lots of crazy, zany pictures, and I like the large font, and sort of got a handwritten kind of style. It's got a little bit of like, a little bit of soul to it. So this was a little tricky. We were asked to find the missing number. We had 2 plus what plus 2 equals 10, and we had to discovered that the missing number was 6, and we used cuisenaire rods to do this. And this was kind of when things started getting a little bit challenging for my daughter. But we kept pushing through it, because that's what us homeschool moms do. And after a while, I realized that it was just not working. This level was not quite working, and my daughter really needed to have her confidence built up. So we put the red book aside, and we went back to the orange book, which, as I mentioned before, is the easiest book. It's the first grade or kindergarten level book. And again, we skipped a lot of the number line stuff, and maybe I shouldn't have skipped that. I like to think that I'm going to go back. And then we came to pages like this. So all the answers on this page are going to be 4, and there's no equal sign on this page, so that kind of threw my daughter off, and she wanted to go ahead and draw in all the equals. So we are asked to find 3 plus what equals 4, 2 plus what equals 4, 1 plus what equals 4, and 0 plus what equals 4. And then we are encouraged to use our cuisenaire rods here. So this one, for instance, would be the 4 rod. And then this one, for instance, would be the 3 rod and the 1 rod. This would be the 1 rod and the 3 rod. This would be a 2 and a 2. And this would be a 1, a 1, a 1, and a 1. So going back and working through this orange book has been really good, and it's given my daughter a lot more confidence, and she's working through the problems very quickly. So in this page, we explore different ways of making 5, and the rods are described using their color: white, red, green, purple, yellow. So yellow is the 5 rod, purple is the 4 rod, and then there's a space for the 1. Green is the 3 rod, and there's the space for the 2. And then R is the red rod, which is 2. And there's the space for the green rod, which is 3. And again, this is going to be the space for the purple rod, which is 4. And there's the space for the white rod, which is 1. I hope that makes sense. I don't know if I'm doing this clearly. So a worksheet like this definitely looked complicated to my daughter. And what we wound up doing was focusing on these kinds of problems, which are like 5 plus what equals 5, 4 plus what equals 5. And by now she has gotten a lot stronger with these types of kind of tricky problems where they're asking you to kind of fill in the blank. And so we did these first, and then again, there's no plus signs here, so my daughter really wanted to add them in, so we did. And so we kind of did these first, and then this was kind of neat. So this was like 2 plus 1 equals 3, 2 plus 2 equals 4. So this was kind of neat, but it definitely looked hard to my daughter. So she was a little intimidated at first, and we had to kind of start this way, and then go here, and then back up to here. And then she realized that she knew how to do it, and it wasn't really that hard. So I don't know if it's coming through in this video, but I really like this curriculum. I don't know anything about mastery versus spiral approach or anything like that, but I just really like all the different ways that these math problems are explored. You know, there's certain things that we just know, like I just know that 9 take away 5 equals 4 because I know that 5 plus 4 equals 9, and I'm not exactly sure how I learned that or when I learned that, but it's just ingrained in my memory. So maybe it was from using a curriculum like this. Maybe it was from a lot of repetition. I don't know, but anyway, so I'm excited about this curriculum. I'm gonna keep using it. There's a lot of potential in here. Like I said, it's all elementary math. I don't think it goes beyond that. And so this is kind of cool. We're already doing multiplication in our orange book, and orange is the easiest one, the beginner book, the kindergarten or first grade book. So I'm excited about that, and I really like it, and I do recommend it. Okay, so I've got my six-year-old daughter with me, Songbird. I want to ask her what she thinks of using Miquon math. Songbird is doing something between a first and second grade level. She's been doing addition and subtraction. What do you think about Miquon math? Do you like it? Tell me what you really think.
I really like it so much.
You really like Miquon math so much?
Sometimes I don't. Sometimes I do.
Sometimes you don't, sometimes you do. Okay, that's good. Thank you for your honesty. Is it hard?
Sometimes hard, but sometimes great.
Sometimes great? I want you to be honest with me. Of all the math curriculum we've used, the good and the beautiful, Life of Fred and Miquon Math, what has been your favorite math curriculum?
My favorite is
Life of Fred. Okay, so your favorite is not Miquon Math. Your favorite is Life of Fred. Is that right? She prefers Life of Fred. Talk to us in the comments and hit the bell if you want to be notified when we upload another video. Have a sublime day.
Yeah.